Okay, we're starting recording. This is Lorana Hancock interviewing Larry Spencer on January 6, 2010. And who is Larry to you?
My great-grandfather.
Okay, Mom's leaving the room. Bye.
Bye,
then.
What's your full name?
Lawrence.
How do you spell that?
L-A-W.
L-A-W.
R-E-N.
R-E-N.
C-E.
C-E.
Chrissy?
How do you spell Chrissy?
C-H?
C-H?
R-I-S?
R-I-S, right?
T-Y?
T-Y.
Spencer.
Oh, and then Hancock?
How do you spell that?
And Spencer? Then the Hancock?
Just Lawrence Christy Spencer.
And when were you born? Like, your birthday?
What is my birthday?
Yeah.
June 20. 1916.
Well, you lived a while.
Well, I was back in the dark ages.
And your great-grandfather. Okay. Where did you grow up?
I was a child in Michigan.
Oh, tell me about it.
We lived on a farm.
I've always wanted to live in
a farm. Yes, about 100 miles north of Detroit. The nearest town was called Cass City, or equally distant, another town, not quite so big, Ubley. I'm about halfway in between Cass City and Ubley.
And
everybody lived on farms up there.
I've always wanted to live on a farm. It's my dream because I love animals. I'm an animal lover, but I don't want to be a veterinarian, so I want to live on a farm like so badly. It would be so cute if I got kittens and chicks. And yeah, and what was your childhood like? My childhood, like, yeah. <clears throat> Well, my mother died when I was seven years old.
And that is a downer. I think before that, my life was a little merrier.
Like
after
happier?
That, it was not quite so merry. But all in all, everybody was pretty nice, and I had a good childhood.
Okay. Can you tell me more about it, or is that all?
I have a great many recollections. Childhood on a farm. My dad had 12 cattle, had one dog.
Wait, don't they have cats?
One cat, four hogs.
Four hogs?
Yes.
Four hogs.
Hog, four pigs.
Oh, I'm like hugs like.
And that, so that varied a little bit from time to time, but it would have new pigs and use the old ones for food.
Oh, but couldn't you get tapeworms?
Yes, in Michigan the climate is much more severe than it is here. It's pleasant, warm in the summer. But along about September, it starts to cool down quite a bit. The leaves start to turn, and all of the maples and elms and ashes and trees like that, the deciduous trees, their leaves will become scarlet, yellow, orange, brown. It's a riot of color.
Syrup. You get the maple
and
syrup
then,
when
and
it's
then they
darn
fall
tasty.
Off. And pretty soon, when the cold weather comes.
Maple syrup, didn't you?
And maple syrup comes along later in the, earlier in the next year, really.
Did you ever get tapeworms from the pigs?
Did I ever get what?
Tapeworms from the pigs. Did you ever get tapeworms from the pigs?
Worms?
No, tapeworms.
Tapeworm. No, I never had a tapeworm.
Well,
But people did have them in those days. I did have pinworms.
I got pinworms just a while ago.
Did you have pinworms too?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I got mine from going barefooted.
Well, I got mine since like my mom left the we're doing gardening stuff and my mom left like our gate open and we think maybe a dog pooped in the backyard because it was always poop and just probably digging around my swing back and we saw and I probably since I played my sandbox with my structure I probably got it from that.
Maybe.
And
but it was a lot of fun living on the farm too. We have a lot of wild berries and wild mushrooms and things like that. You just go out and pick them.
One of my dreams is to live on a farm.
It's a great place to live if you don't have to do the farming.
I've always wanted to have many animals, many kittens, many bunnies. The one thing that made me more like it and encouraged me more to do it is I had a dream. I had tons of cats, tons of bunnies, tons of chicks. Thought it would just be so fun if I could own a farm and have so many animals. My teacher lived on a farm.
Farming now is much different than it was then.
My teacher lived on a farm too. She said she got bumped off of a horse.
My dad had a Fordson tractor. And he pulled the plows and the harrows and things like that with the tractor. Then later on, we had to bring in hay for the winter. Everything was work. We had a lot of potatoes. We always grew potatoes. And that was for us to eat.
Yeah, potatoes are so darn tasty.
We had buckwheat, make buckwheat pancakes. We had oats.
And maple syrup to go on the pancakes and butter.
Yeah.
And cheese. Cheese.
We had winter wheat and spring wheat, rye, things like that, corn. And we grew cucumbers, tomatoes, squash, summer crops. And you mentioned maple syrup. My dad had a big maple syrup operation. He went to a lot of trouble to make a big evaporator. And I think he evaporated probably maybe 10,000 gallons of sap.
Wow, that's a lot. Must have had like tons of trees.
It takes about 50 gallons of sap to make a gallon of syrup. You would have all together maybe a couple hundred gallons of syrup. So that's a lot of sap. And he had to cut all the wood to make the fires to boil the sap. And he used a thermometer to tell when to take the syrup off. It's much hotter than just boiling water. Boiling water boils at 212. And that syrup came off at about 225.
Oh.
So it was pretty heavy with sugar. But it tasted great.
I know.
You like maple syrup?
Yeah. Because especially since you live on a farm, you have cows, so you make butter and you have wheat. So you can make pancakes plus maple syrup. You have perfect pancakes. You know what? My choir teacher, one time we were doing this Christmas concert, and she lived on a farm too, and she fell off the haystack.
Wow.
And she had like her back was like broken.
Another thing we grew a lot of was beans. We grew lots of what we call Michigan medium beans. The white beans. And when they cooked, it smelled so good.
I don't really like beans, but.
One time I got fooled quite badly. School got out about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and our farm was only about a mile from school. And when I was walking home, I could smell this wonderful scent. Oh, did it smell so good. beans cooking. So I started to run a little bit, and after I get a little bit tired, I walk a while, and then run again, and I finally got home, and my dad had a great big cauldron, really big. It's,
like a witch's cauldron?
It would take two of you to reach around it, and it was kind of bulbous, like a semicircle, and it had about 30 or 40 gallons in it. And it turned out to be...
No wonder it had such a strong smell.
That was the cull beans that had all the bad beans in it, but it sure still smelled good. But I couldn't eat any. It had stones and things like that right in with the beans. And the beans themselves were... they're not perfect beans. They had discolorations and spots on them and things like that. Mm-hmm. They smelled good.
They probably sure did.
We used to make most of the stuff we ate. We grew quite a few vegetables in the garden. We canned a lot of berries, because we had back in the sugar bush where all those maple trees were, there were big patches of blackberries. And my grandparents would come down and go back with my parents, and they'd have 4 or 5 5-gallon milk cans and fill those up with berries.
I don't like blueberries or raspberries, or whatever they're called.
My mother would can most of those berries. We'd have maybe some cobbler or pie.
I like pumpkin pie.
With the fresh berries. Pumpkin After pie. That, it was canned berries. I used to make mincemeat. And part that I didn't like was in about November, after everything froze up, then you'd butcher a hog. And I didn't like to be around that. But I was maybe a little bit two-faced, because I ate it.
Did your parents force you to eat it?
We had lots of wild animals back too. Oh, there were lots of raccoons, mink, muskrat.
What's muskrat?
Weasels, woodchucks, rabbits.
What are woodchucks and muskrats?
Muskrat?
What are muskrats and woodchucks?
Woodchuck?
Yeah.
A woodchuck, I don't know, it's kind of a... he just eats grass roots, I guess, and other vegetation, but they dig holes in the ground. And if your horse steps in one, it might break a leg, and then you have to kill the horse. They do that. The horse breaks a leg, they kill the horse. Because they never heal.
What are muskrats? Before that, are the woodchucks those beavers or something? I forgot what they're called, but they like go underground and stuff. And I forgot.
We used to have foxes there. Foxes and skunks. Weasels. Ferrets were always trying to steal the chickens. It was a constant battle. And then in the sky there'd be hawks that would be watching for your chickens too. Chicken hawks. It was quite a continuous battle to keep your chickens.
Oh.
You had to have some extras, because we had to eat a lot of chicken too.
Did you have to get out and go?
In the summer, when it was not freezing, you had to have the chicken, something you could use up right away. And then you do the butchering in November, the meat would stay frozen all winter.
Yeah, but who are your favorite relatives?
Actually, life is much better now.
But who are your favorite relatives?
We had a lot of fun, you know. We went down to the swamp, we got our own Christmas tree.
Yeah, but was your aunt your favorite relative?
And we made popcorn strings, paper chains to decorate the Christmas tree.
With who?
We put big red and white chains from corner to corner of the room.
With who?
Merry Christmas.
With who though? Who would you?
Pardon?
Who would you do all this stuff with? Your parents?
My mother, my sister, I. Mom might have pitched in a little bit down there. You got the tree in the first place.
Do you know who your favorite relatives were?
My favorite relatives? Mm-hmm. I had cousins that lived very near.
Were they your favorite relatives?
My father's sister had a boy that lived about my age too. He just lived about a quarter of a mile away. And my mother's sister and father's brother had several kids, but less than 1 mile away.
So you're saying your cousins are your favorite relatives?
They finally had 9 all together, but on the farm, and I would say they only had about 7.
But are you cousins your favorite relatives, or?
What's that, Donna?
Are your cousins your favorite relatives?
Yes, my cousins are my favorite relatives.
Oh. Do you remember any stories they used to tell you?
They used to have ghost stories.
Can you tell me more about it?
There was one. Where the ghost said, "It floats.
It floats.
It floats.
It floats."
And it turned out to be ivory soap.
It floats. Ivory soap.
All the scary details. But it floats. That's the main line.
Do you remember any
stories
Great-grandma and
Helen
and you meet?
Helen and my sister Leona were classmates at nursing school. And Leona brought Helen and one of her other classmates home 2 or 3 times. But during the same time I came home, I was in school at the University of Michigan. And Helen was, and my sister and Angie were at Mercy Hospital in Detroit, and taking nursing. And they would come home, I think, almost every weekend. But I would come home probably once a month, and I met them then. And I don't know, we just got better acquainted. And after we both graduated, we dated. And we got married.
What was my daddy like growing up?
What?
What was my dad like growing up?
Your dad?
Yeah.
He was a nice kid. He worked hard. He had a Sacramento Bee paper out, and he used to deliver those papers sometimes. One paper would weigh about 5 pounds, that's how big they were on Sunday.
My dad would deliver those?
And he'd have to take 2 or 3 trips to get them.
Well, my dad did that?
Yes.
Whoa. Whoa. At least I don't do that stuff.
No.
Do you remember any songs that you used to sing?
Any songs you used to sing?
To Daddy, and can you sing them now?
I remember some songs my dad used to sing.
Yeah, but can you sing them now?
Not very much.
Can you try?
But yeah, I think of a few of them. It was one about, where has my Highland laddie gone? He's gone to fight the foe for King George upon the throne. But it's all in my heart that I wish him safe at home. That's what I'm... Let's see, there's one called The Happy Feather War. I don't remember very much about it, except that there was one line that said, "'Twas a relic of old decencies, the Happy Feather War." And I was a lot older before I found out that decencies really meant customs. But that was the word for it that they had. Yeah, they sang lots of other songs too that have kind of passed out of our knowledge anymore.
Was my daddy well behaved?
Yes, he was. Your pa was a nice kid.
I thought he was really mischievous and stuff.
All little things, you know.
Yeah. I heard my dad was really mischievous, and he put a penny through that wall, and it would push. His hair would push. And he also heard when he was older, he like choked his brother or something.
I remember one time I caught your dad and Chris on an April Fool's joke.
What did he do to you?
I used to walk on the levee down by the American River during noon hour, and over a period of about 6 months, I got about 8 or 10 really egg-shaped stones, just the right size and the right shape. I put blue dots on them and put them in the weeds. And then on April Fool's Day, I hollered at the guys that I found a nest from a rock hen nest. And it all came running and looked into the weeds, and sure enough, there were all those eggs and blue spots on. And Chris reached down and touched it. He says, "It's a stone!" At April Fool's.
What was the worst thing my dad ever did?
The worst thing your dad ever did? I can't remember any bad stuff your dad did.
Well, let's just say, like, I heard my dad one time, he put that penny through his pocket and his hair went out. Let's just say that's the worst thing he ever did. I'm sure he did much worse, but I don't know. Okay. What were your parents like?
What was the question?
What was your parents like? Like, how did they treat you?
What was that?
What were your parents like?
My parents. They were nice people. Both of them. Upstanding citizens.
Do you know anything more about them?
Pardon?
Can you say anything more about them?
They worked hard. Made a living on the farm. Raised my sister and me till Mama died. Then we were kind of split up. I didn't see my sister a whole lot after that. Ever. And well, no, I gotta take that back because we were both with Pa and Port Huron that for a time.
That's so
but she
sad.
Was a different place than me a lot. She was a good kid too. My sister was a dandy girl.
What were your great-great-grandparents like?
One of my grandparents had died before I was born. I never knew her. It was my father's mother. Her maiden name was Alma Holmes. I have a picture of her. She was a beautiful girl.
There's a junior high called Holmes.
Pardon?
There's a junior high called Holmes.
Yes?
Yeah.
And my father's father was Horace Cassius Spencer. And he had a high school education, which was unusual in those days. 1890 or thereabouts. Before that, I was born about 1890.
Can you say anything more about them?
And my mother's father was Jay Britton, and my mother's mother, her maiden name was Louisa Moore, M-O-O-R-E. But I never knew any of my great-grandparents. I have a little bit of information about some of them, though. Can't remember their names. Except, of course, one of them was a Spencer.
Should we move on to the next question?
Yeah.
How would you like to be remembered?
How would I like to be?
Remembered.
Remembered?
Mm-hmm.
As a guy that like to have fun, I guess.
Oh. Should we move on?
Yeah.
Are you proud of me?
Any?
Are you proud of me?
Yes, I'm proud of you. Yeah, because you're a really outstanding lady.
Thank you. And we just have a few more questions. Well, they're not on this clipboard, but my mom thought of them. I think my teacher should have put these because she probably didn't think of them, but they're like really interesting questions. Like, when you were growing up, you saw all the things change. Like, when you were little, like, trains were invented.
Oh, things have changed so much.
What was your favorite thing that changed?
I never even saw a radio until 1923.
Do you have a favorite thing you liked about it?
What's that?
Do you have a favorite thing you liked?
Favorite name?
No, like a favorite thing, like, as you saw everything changed, like, deep. Do you now like there's cars? What was your favorite thing that's now invented?
Well, almost everything along the line of science has changed so much. Cars and airplanes, rocket ships now, satellites.
So you can't decide what you like the most about it?
What's it now?
So you can't decide what you like the most?
Oh. Well, I don't know, television and computers came along. Yeah, it's really hard to say, but maybe some of the medical advances are the things that I like the most. I've had all the childhood diseases because they didn't have any vaccinations for hardly anything except smallpox.
You mean you got chickenpox?
I think maybe they had got a handle on diphtheria by then, because I never had it. And I didn't catch smallpox, but scarlet fever, but my sister did.
Daddy did too.
Scarlet fever was bad.
My dad got it.
Yeah,
my dad was burning up. He had to go to the bath, cold water. That's what I heard.
My sister got the mumps, but I never got that either.
I heard of it. Yeah. I heard like your cheeks are sort of like...
It had chicken pox and the measles and German measles and whooping cough.
That's sad. Do you...
Now these kids don't have so many of those diseases. And a bad one that they used to have was polio.
Really?
Yeah, that was crippling or even killing. It was bad.
It is.
Scarlet fever was bad.
Did you have a favorite toy when you were little?
A favorite toy?
Like a teddy bear?
My favorite toy was my BB gun.
Of course, boys love guns and stuff and violence.
Well, if I got a BB gun when I was 6 years old.
Six? I think you should at least get one when you're 10 or 11. When you're 6, you could just shoot your parents.
Daisy. It was a Daisy BB gun.
Daisy, you mean like, never mind. You mean, well, we'll just say it anyways. You mean like a Daisy BB gun with daisies all over the gun?
They used to have lead pellets, P people didn't know how bad lead was in those days. All us kids had pockets that were maybe not full or partly full of lead BBs.
That's bad. Because now we use for pencils, graphite, I think. The Daisy gun, was that just called what it was called, or did you use daisies as the bullets?
Yeah, we didn't have any radio or television when it was born. First radio when about 7 years old, and no TV until 1950, maybe.
Some kids, like now how we have DSs and DSIs and TV, some kids like watch TV and say, I will die without it. I have to have it, and stuff like that. But yeah, just a few more questions. Well, maybe like one more. When you saw things change, did you like how it happened? As things changed, did it go really slowly?
Yeah, I think most of the things that have come along, I like the change.
And did it go really slow?
Automobiles and airplanes are much, much, much safer, faster, more efficient. Oh, so much better than they were when I was a kid.
Yeah, because I heard now we have, they search us to see if we have metal or we have airplane. Yeah, so it's a lot more safer.
Yeah, we have materials now that didn't exist back in those days.
Did you have fish tanks or turtles then?
What was that now?
Did you have fish tanks and fishes in it, or turtles, or bunnies, or guinea pigs, or mice then? You know, as pets?
No. I think the only pets we ever had were goldfish.
I have goldfish at home. But they're really pretty.
We never had hamsters or anything like that.
Well,
rabbits.
Was your fish? Did you have a fish tank, or did you have just a kind of like bowl where you put them in or something?
Yeah, we had two goldfish. One of them's name was Chloe.
There's a girl named Chloe in my class.
Chloe,
her name's Chloe
McLean. Can't remember the other one. They both died from tobacco.
Tobacco? Do you know how they got tobacco? And what is tobacco?
Tobacco is a plant that produces leaves that people like to chew or smoke, or I don't think they eat it, but mostly smoke the leaves, yeah. But it has a lot of nicotine in it.
What's nicotine?
Nicotine is an alkaloid that produces addiction.
How did the fish get tobacco?
What was that question?
Then how did the fish get tobacco and die?
Somebody came in the house and smoked a cigarette, and the fish died.
And you know how you have your fish? Was it in a fish tank, a bowl, or
bowl,
what?
Fish bowl, yeah.
Goldfish are supposed to have those air pumpers, like a... I thought they were supposed to have those air pumpers that have bubbles so the water has air. Well, that's what I have. Mm-hmm. Maybe one time you can come over and see my goldfish. They're really pretty. Now we have places where you can buy fish and stuff. Well, that's basically all the questions. So we're basically done with the interview. Mama!
Larry needs to say how old he is.
How old are you?
I'm 93.
But he's turning 94. Isn't that old? He is He survived for like a long time.
He's older than some people and younger.
He's almost 100. Isn't that so exciting?
Larry, when were you born?
June 20, 1916. She has that.
Oh, okay, great.
June 20, 1916. Oh. So here's just a quick check. The name of the interviewee is Lawrence Christie Spencer. He was born June 20th, 1916. And he is my great-grandpa, Larry Spencer. Goodbye!
Bye-bye.
No, wait. Before you do that, wave. You gotta wave.
Bye.
Bye.